Okay, so if you're planning an event and you want to create a registration form, you want to use it to gather some data from the people that will respond to the form. And then when you're done with it, you want to analyze those responses. We're going to go through how to do that. And we're going to just start out in Google Drive. So if you have a Google account, you have access to Google Drive. Just go to drive.google.com and it will bring you to kind of the homepage of Google Drive that will look like this. And I just navigated through a couple folders, so I had a blank space here to start. So first we want to just create the form. And to do that, go up to the plus sign, left click on it. And we're going to go to more because this isn't one of the three main apps. So you go to more and you go to Google Forms. So in Google Forms, we're still not quite there yet. What we want to do is pick from one of these two options. So you could do a blank form if you want, but there is a template for event registration. So we're left clicked on that and we're going to pick that just because it is a little bit of a head start and it may have some question types that you want to keep. So just left click on event registration. And when it comes up, chances are you're going to want to customize it, right? So as a nice picture here, let's choose a different one. Let's say that we're going to do, it's going to be a volunteering event and we're going to be cleaning up a park. So we want to first just change this picture. And in order to change the look and feel, you come up kind of in the upper right-hand corner here and you left click on customize theme. And then the header is what we want to change. So left click on image uploaded. And let's just get an illustration that looks nice for a park. I like this one. Left click on insert. And then that'll change that look. And let's change the header here of the document. Save the park. Give them some basic information where it is. I know it's hot right now, but it's going to be in June anyway. Let's make it soon. We don't want to give people too much of a warning. It's June 27th and it's right now. That's going to date this video. Oh well. And event address. So maybe you're just going to send this out to your faithful citizens so they'll know where the park is, but we'll say, well, we didn't specify what park, did we? We'll say it's Wolcott Park. It sounds old and fancy. Wolcott Park. Contact us at, I'll just leave that off for now. I want to get going with the form, right? Rid of that. Okay, now we're ready to move on to the questions that we want to ask. So think of this as the data that you want coming in. So when you look at who's registered, these are going to be the important things that you need to think about. The first thing that we're going to ask is name, and that's already on this form. You don't have to ask it. You can change this to something else if you want. But name can be useful for multiple reasons, but one of the things that you can do with it is check for duplicates. So someone might have forgotten that they registered, they go in and register again. You'll see their name on there twice, so you can accommodate for that when you're planning to see how many people come. And we're going to take a peek at this form as we go along to see what's happening. So let's go in the upper right-hand corner, left click on preview. It'll open a new tab and let's take this one and put it on the right. And we'll take the original form and we'll put it on the left. Now you don't have to do this as you go through. I'm just doing this to kind of help us see what the end result is. So let's though stay on the left-hand side right now and look at designing this. So we have the question of name and it's a short answer is what it's saying it is. And what that means is when you left click on this, you can choose from different question types and short answer is just think of a little text box. Right? And the user can type a couple different words. You could also do paragraph, which just is designed to take in more words, but I wouldn't think your name would be that long. So short answer is fine. And we'll touch on these different types a little bit later. So when you look at the right, this is what that's going to look like. This asks for name and just a little box for you to type it out. And there is a red asterisk and that's defined at the top as required. And that's being driven by this slider to the right of required. So you probably want to ask for name. If you don't want them to feel compelled to put that in there, then you just left click on required. We'll do that for later questions. So we're going to leave that required. And let's say you may want to get in contact with them. So the next thing, so since we're using a template, it's already here, right? We want their email, so that's handy. But let's left click on this email. So some things are going on here. What they've done with this field is that they've come to the lower right hand corner, left clicked on these three dots, and they're validating the response. And that's handy because in this case, if someone types in no email, this is going to kick that out because the response has to be text. So this drop down, they've selected text, and the type of text is email address. So if there's no email address here, it won't accept this answer. You could do that with a phone number too if you wanted to. So it's a kind of a handy way just to keep the inputs working and get the data that you want. So this next question will say, what type of volunteering do you want to do? So, and this is just going to be one of two things. So when we drop down the question type, let's use multiple choice. You'll get to see what this looks like. And option one will be tree planting. And before we add the next option, if you take a look here, you can left click on add option. That's what you would do. Or if you add other, that gives the user a blank space to type in something else. But if you were only offering two things, let's just say tree planting and litter removal. But you don't want to have this be required. You don't want to overwhelm the user. If they just want to click submit, you don't want to lose them. So don't make it required. And let's come over to the right and refresh and see how we're doing. All right, so we have name, email, type of volunteering. So when I left click on tree planting and then change my mind to litter removal, it only allows one of these to be selected at a time. All right, so let's come back. We did type of volunteering. Now let's just do, you're going to ask, do you have any restrictions? And this one is going to be just a yes or no. And we'll just do it as a slightly different type. So you can also do them as a drop down. And the first one could be yes. And the second one could be no. We'll get rid of the third option. But with this question, what we want to do is if they answer yes, we want to bring them to an additional question. But if they answer no, we want them to just move on with the form. So in order to do that, we need to add a section. All right, we're going to call this section restrictions. And then under here, we're going to say, what type of restrictions? So let's allow them on this one, you can have more than one answer. So we will do checkboxes and we'll say, is it mobility restriction? Is it, I don't know, maybe you're on your probation, right? You have a bracelet and we need to know that for some reason. I don't know, I'm struggling here. Mobility, probation, makes no sense. And maybe you're a minor, so you need to have your parents. We'll get rid of these other answers. And that's it for section two, because that's just if you answer yes for restrictions. We're going to add another section, and this is going to be called time of day. So let's circle back to the do you have any restrictions. What we want to do is left click on go to section based on answer. If they click yes, we'll continue to next section, which is restrictions. If they say no, then we'll go to section three, time of day. Okay, so let's come down to time of day. That's just a section header, so it needs a question. We'll say what time works best for you. Now you really might just want to have this multiple choice. Maybe you're only running it at two different times, but I'm doing it this way because I just want to show you that you can ask for a time. Or you can ask for a date. So we'll click time. And then the only thing that you can input for this answer is a time. All right, so let's say we're ready to preview this form again, or let's just left click on preview. We'll bring that preview over to the right and check out what we have so far. So let's enter a name, email address. I guess I could do my real name, right? I think I'll be okay with that. Type of volunteering, let's say litter removal. Do I have any restrictions? Yes. And then you have to left click on next. Then it brings you to what type. I'm on probation. Well, that's not funny, is it? We'll click next. And then the time. It gives you this format where you have to enter a time. Right? There's a little colon there already. Invalid time. Well, just hold your horses. 7:33. Click submit. And there you go. So they've received the registration. And because of the settings that you have, they can come in and edit their response later. You can turn that off if you want, But let's come over to the left and just look at this response, and then we'll talk about different ways that you can send out this registration. So you have one response already. This is obviously what I just did. We'll left click on that, and it will give you data about all your responses so you can analyze what's going on. And you can also look at this and say, maybe you can make a decision that this time of day needs to be just a drop down with a couple of selections. So you could change the form as you go along. But for now, this is where you go to get responses, and you download them in a spreadsheet here, but we'll talk about that after we put some more data in here. So if you're just about ready to set it out, let's check our settings to make sure that they make sense. You can collect email addresses if you want, and you can give the respondents a copy of their responses if you want. So, and here's where you would uncheck edit after submit. Now, this is just a registration form, so if you're not worried about it, I would just leave that on. I don't think you need to change anything. If you left click on presentation, you can show them that little progress bar as they click through it. I would just leave most of these as is because this form isn't long enough to have to show someone a progress bar. So just click save, and let's say we're ready to send this out. So this is some of the flexibility of Google Forms will come through here. When you left click on send, you'll get a box that comes up, and at the top, there are three different options on how to send this out. You can just type in email addresses. So when this envelope has been clicked, down here is the to field, and you would just type in all the email addresses that you have, or you could just paste them in here. And you can embed the actual form in the email if you want. So you would check mark here to do that. And you can add other people to have them help you send out the form here. So if I left click on add collaborators, it will give you this add editors box, and then you could type in some of your, let's say, team members there. Let's go back up to send. So that's a traditional sending it through email. What you could do is grab this link, and you could even left click and shorten URL to get a shorter link. And you could do whatever you want with that link. So you could copy that link. You could send it out in a text and an email. You could send it out in social media, and then if someone left clicks on that, it will bring them to the form. And while we're on the subject of social media, there are two embedded options here to make it a little bit easier. So you could share it via Facebook or Twitter just from clicking here, and that would bring that up in another tab. So I'll show you that. Let's say we'll do it through Twitter. Save the park. So this is the email. Left click on that to send out that tweet. No, I don't want to do that. And then the last option is to get some embed code. So if you're a website owner and you can access the HTML on the back end, you would copy this text, you would put it on your website, and then this form would just show up in a window on your website. And then so you could gather submissions through your existing site. So one more trick while we're in here, if you wanted to say print posters about saving the park and you wanted people to be able to just take a picture of the QR code on the poster, what you could do is come to the link. You could grab this link and then just go to a QR code creator. I really don't know one of these from the other, but you can create a QR code. So you put that URL. So let's make sure we still have that URL on our clipboard. We'll copy it. We'll paste it. And then you can take this QR code, you can put it on a piece of paper, you could put it in your local, grocery store if you want. People scan that with their phone, and then that would take them directly to the form. All right, so let's say we've sent this form out and now we have six responses. We're going to talk about what you can do with these now. So we're still in the Google form. If I left click on responses, and there's three options and different ways to look at them before you even use a spreadsheet. So the summary is just going to summarize them by question type. So that's pretty intuitive. Gives you some charts. You can look at them by question. So this was the question of the name. You can scroll through those. Or by individual respondent. So this is everything that the first person answered. Scroll through, let's say, with the third person answer. This right here. So this can be handy. And if you're only expecting a couple people, you probably can just analyze it like this. If you have a larger number of responses, what you can do is come up to the icon of a spreadsheet, left click, it's saying create spreadsheet. We'll just keep it on, create a new spreadsheet. What you could also do is filter it into an existing spreadsheet. So it would just create a new sheet within there. But let's just say we want a new one. And it just created the spreadsheet, but let's go back to Drive for a second. So I still have that tab open. I just wanted to show you, this is why we talked about where this is saved in Drive. So now your form and your spreadsheet are saved in the same folder. And that's good, right? Because they belong together. And it named it the name of your form and then just put responses in parentheses. So let's go into that spreadsheet. And this is giving you a list of everyone that registered. So the one thing that we want to ignore on mine is I did it in a corporate account, so it's collecting all the email addresses of the people at the company. You can see it was just me, but we'll right click on that. We're going to hide the column. You won't see that on a personal account. So let's talk about what we're seeing here. It's showing you when the responses came in, giving you the list of names. This is all pretty straightforward so far, but let's say you wanted to come in here and look at who needs restrictions. So you see this extra field that we designed, it's only filled out for one person. But if this list had thousands of people, what you could do is you could go to data and then create a filter. And that puts these little controls at the top of each column. And if you wanted to just look at the people that have restrictions, you could left click on that control, uncheck the no's, click OK, and then you would just have a list of everyone with a yes. Let's clear that out. Select all again, click OK, and then everyone comes back. If you're trying to figure out how to staff this, find out what time works best, maybe you want to sort this by time of day. So you could left click on this and sort A to Z. And it puts it in time order. And then you could see how many people are going to be showing up at different times of day. Now this also collects all your email addresses. So if you were to copy this, you could paste this somewhere else and work with the email addresses. Maybe you want to communicate with them further. And if you have staff lined up, right, and you want to give someone a list of the people that are doing litter removal, uncheck tree planting, and there you go. That's all the litter removal people. So that's how to use Google Forms. If you want to learn more about how to sort and filter data once you get it inside of Google Sheets, this next video will walk you through some of those concepts.